Hi, my name is Kenator, and welcome back to another Starbase video. Before we get started, I'd like to invite you to my new Discord to further discuss all things Starbase. Please find a link in the description below after you finish watching. If you are impressed by the battle you saw in my last Starbase video and can't wait to get blasting up some ships, well, hold on, buddy, because you're going to need a ship of your own first. So let's get right into that. But Kenator, I hear you cry, we can just buy ships from the stations. Now yes, you could go to a station and buy a pre-made ship, but where's the fun in that? What if you wanted to go faster? Or you could even want to build all your ships with cat ears, because that's your jam. Or add DACA, because let's face it, you're always gonna want more DACA. So stay tuned for the weapons section. Introducing the ultimate in space engineering, the bolt gun. This tool will quickly become your most used tool in the game, using everything from building, removing, salvage, sabotage, and even stealing enemy components and ships. When using this tool, all bolts are highlighted in a bright cyan colour. In Starbase, everything has to be bolted down. And what do you bolt first? Well, that's the framework. This is going to be the core component that is going to hold your magnificent contraption together. It is also where you really see how much you're going to need to plan out and how much time you're going to need to successfully craft your ship. As I've said before, Starbase ships are literally crafted out of nuts and bolts. Your frame will ultimately decide the overall silhouette of your ship, its shape and outline, basically how you want it to be seen by other players. There are many modular frame parts and are even available to download as Frozenbyte gave them out to the community. I'll throw a link in the description. Next up, it's time to put in the walls, the floor, and the armour that's going to keep you safe. Most of this will sit directly on the beams, but can still protrude to a certain extent. We will know more details of the armour and its materials as it's released, and I'll be sure to cover this when it does, and I'll throw a link up in the corner for this video. From information we have so far, the armour plating is made from pre-sized and shaped panels, which if you so wish can be cut and shaped with the cutting laser. Each panel will need to be bolted down, and it's up to you to decide how many bolts, but it looks like 2 to 4 is a good amount, depending on the piece. Now it's time to get your ship moving! It's time to put thrusters on the ship, and we have 3 to choose from, but you will probably end up using them all. We have simple maneuvering thrusters, key if you ever want to turn your ship, and then we have 2 main thrusters, in the smaller triangle one and the main box thrusters. The devs have said that these have to be bolted directly to the main ship, so sadly, no Serenity or Prometheus designs with moving engines unless we get some changes. These thrusters, like many components, are built from modular pieces that slot together and can be stacked on any side, which I think could make some interesting angular engine pods. But we still won't be moving with just these. You're going to need some fuel tanks and a power plant for your ship. This is where we really see the modularity pop up a notch. The generator, comprised of its fuel chamber in which sits a fuel rod, this is what you'll replace over time as it depletes. As this chamber converts this into processed fuel for your generator units, it also generates heat, as does the generator unit itself. Be mindful of this when designing your engine rooms. The fuel chamber has 2 connection ports on each side and 1 to the rear. Feel free to pop the generator on any of these 9 ports, but typically we've seen this on the back. The generator unit itself has a connector on each side too. Why all these connectors though? Well, you need space for a cooling board or 2 to absorb some of that heat. These use cooling cells which are slotted into it, so make sure this is accessible. There are enhancers that you can add to the system too, but we are waiting for more details on what and how many types of enhancements will be available, but we can safely assume that these are going to be efficiency based. And finally, you got to get all this power to the rest of your ship, with the socket board. More on what plugs into here in a moment. Now we have what we need to make the ship move, it's best that we add one of the few seats available and build a control center. These switches, buttons and levers the game has, they need to be connected to your thrusters via simple YOLOL commands. If you're concerned over this, don't be. In no time at all, these simple commands will be second nature, and I'll cover more on YOLOL in another video. Finally, we have our last essential components, the flight control units and the main flight computer. The flight control units have a specific orientation and are connected to your various thruster groups, and they can come in upgraded variants, most likely for larger amounts of thrusters. These are then connected to your main flight computer. This computer makes sure all your thrusters work cohesively together. Which brings me to connecting all of these components together. We of course need some way of getting power and data transferred to everything. Unlike space engineers, for example, it does not flow through your ship automatically. Introducing the cable tool and its big brother, the piping tool. We can now connect up all the controls to the flight computer and the power center of your ship. With a simple point-and-click method, cabling is run along any surface and can be spliced into other cables without any extra components. Be careful with your placement though, as this can be cut through or damaged when your armor is penetrated, possibly leaving you a sitting duck. The pipe tool works in the exact same way, but is used between your propellant tanks and your thrusters. And there we have it, a working ship! But come on, this is really only going to get you from A to B. And you want to blow something up, right? Maybe transport some cargo? Okay, let's see what else we can put in there. A good start would be something like a door to get in or out of your ship. For this we can use hinge blocks and some more armor plating, as well as a button for opening, and yes, you guessed it, power by Yolol again. There will be no avoiding it for these simple things. Yolol needed to run these different aspects is stored on Yolol chips, and the chips are kept in modular racks which are also connected to your power and data network within the ship. For communication we have radio transmitters and receivers. We have cheap cargo crates for basic storage and advanced modular crates which act like mini TARDIS-like storage crates, shrinking your items for transport and saving you a lot of space. Be careful though, should these lose power, the rapid expansion of your cargo might give your ship a whole new look as your cargo blows a hole through your ship. For bigger items, you can put them in a cargo lock frame. Within this area, nothing will move once activated and can be built to whatever size is needed. For even bigger cargo once more, stolen ships, there is the cargo beam. This will lock items in place when hit by at least three of them. But you're going to need a tractor beam as well if you want to pull that cargo into the cargo beams for transport. This of course will be great use to miners as well to bring that golden nugget back home for safer and quicker mining. Speaking of mining, your ships can also do this too thanks to the handy mining laser. Don't forget there are also lights and display panels that you can put throughout your ship. Space can be pretty dark, you know. And finally, we have what you've all been waiting for, the weapons. Now to mount your weapons, you can either use a fixed mount, or you can go a step further and attach this to a turntable. For your choice in Ultimate Dacker, you can choose between the autocannon, laser cannon, the rail cannon, and the plasma thrower. Just don't ask me why they didn't call that cannon too. Like the engine and power plant, these are built from pieces and generate heat as well. The autocannon is a standard fast shooting projectile weapon that fires in a wide spread. The laser cannon is an energy weapon that will draw from your ship's reactor to shoot, and is quite accurate with very little spread. The rail cannon has a long charge time and shoots highly destructive slugs that will pierce even the heaviest of armor. Just don't miss. The plasma thrower is another energy weapon, but is slow to fire, but deals special fracture damage, tearing shards off your ship in addition to slowing the ship that it hits. But that's not all, my friends, we also have missiles. Now information on these is light at the moment as they are still in development, but you can be sure you're going to be able to wreck some havoc. They are deadfire missiles, so no homing as of yet, but I am very much looking forward to using these. But let me know your favourite in the comments below. With all that weapons fire, what happens after you've won a fight, but your ship is full of holes? But don't worry, we have two last tools for you. First up is the building tool, an incredible tool that can be used to paint back missing parts of your ship, providing you have the resources on hand. Or if rebuilding a ship from scratch, back at the station, it'll also fill in a blueprint for you. That's right, you only need to design that ship once, and future copies can be printed out hassle-free, at least for the most part. And as damage is not just skin deep, you'll need the durability tool. With it you can see how damaged your ship's frame is in a sort of x-ray vision, as well as panels that are not properly secured that will fly off your ship when you fly away. It can also be used to see if you're designing your ship properly too. With so many bolts, you may miss a few. Now you know what you need, what will you make? Are there any ship designs out there that inspire you to recreate them in Starbase? How much Dacker is truly enough for one ship? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Kenator, out.